Assalamu alaikum everyone and students, this topic I know you all have done before, but we are just having a revision of this topic. So what you have to do, take out your science books and open chapter number 12, the solar system and beyond. Moving to page number 258. The sun, earth and moon. If you were given a light source, a tennis ball and a football, how would you use them to represent the sun, earth and moon? Why did you represent them the way you did? Is your model of the sun, earth and moon system an accurate representation of the actual system? The sun, earth and moon cannot be represented accurately by models or diagrams because the sun is much bigger than the earth and moon is very far from them. Okay, students, here they are saying if you were given a light source, okay, for example, if you were given a tennis ball one and a football. So, can you represent the sun with the moon? Can you represent the sun, earth and the moon with them? And why did you represent them the way you did? For example, if in this picture, she is having a ball, okay? And she is representing sun. Same with the football. And he is representing the earth and a ball. He is representing the moon. So, is it accurate or not? No. Why? Because we cannot accurately define the models or diagrams because obviously the sun is much bigger. Okay. As you can see that over here, sun is, if she is showing the diagram, model of a sun, so it's not accurate because earth is being the biggest than the sun, but it's not like that because sun is much bigger than the earth as well and then the moon as well, so we cannot represent them accurately through the models or diagrams. Moving to page number 259. The sun is a light source as it gives out its own light. Objects which gives out light are known as luminous objects. We can see them when the light they give reaches out our eyes. A full moon appears bright. It is also a light source. Not all bright objects are light sources. The moon do not give out its own light. Objects which do not give out its own light are known as non-luminous objects. We can see non-luminous objects when they reflect light into our eyes. The moon reflects the sun's light, and when the reflected light enters into our eyes, we see the moon. Okay. So, students, on page number 259, they are telling us about the difference between luminous objects and non-luminous objects. So, there are some objects which gives out their own light, okay? There are some objects which gives out their own light and we call them luminous objects. For example, sun. Sun gives its own light. So it's a luminous object. But if we talk about the moon, so beta, there are some objects which do not give their own light, which do not give out their own light, but they take the help from other objects. For example, moon. Moon beta do not shine or moon do not gives out its own light. Whereas it takes the light of a sun and then it shines. Otherwise, moon do not have its own light. Moving to page number 260. The earth, like the moon, is a non-luminous object. We can see moonlight from the earth. Do you think we can see earth light from the moon? What is the cause of our air? People used to believe that the earth was the center of the universe and the sun revolved around the earth. Now we know that it is not true. The earth, in fact, revolves around the sun in an elliptical, it means oval path or orbit. Okay, so students, first of all, that how air causes, it means how we can recognize that it's a 2020 year, 2021 year is coming right now, and how. So first of all, in the past, people used to think that the earth was the center of the universe. Okay, it means when we talk about the solar system, so people in the past thinks that the earth was the center of the universe and that the sun revolved around the earth, and they think that the sun revolves around the earth. But when research have been done and there were theories given by scientists and all, so it was decided that the earth, that it was not a true, the statement which was in the past was not true. The earth, in fact, revolves around the sun. In which direction, beta? In which orbit? In an oval orbit, not in the circle orbit, in an oval orbit. Moving to page number 261. The earth takes 365, one upon in 4 days, it means one earth year, to make revolution around the sun at a speed of 110,000 kilometers per hour. Compare this to the speed of a fast moving car on a highway, which is about 110 kilometers per hour. A year on earth is the time taken for the earth to go around the sun once. Okay, students, over here they are saying that when earth revolves around the sun, so what it takes 365 and one upon in 4 days, it means one earth year to have a complete rotation. Okay, just one rotation it takes in 1 year to revolve around the sun, and the sun speed is beta 110,000 kilometer. For example, if we have a car and we are moving from a highway road, so what will happen that we used to speed up till 110 kilometer, and you can see the speed of a sun when it revolves. Okay, so it means it has a much higher speed, and a year on earth is the time taken for the earth to go around the sun once. Okay, I told you that what is the year, that once when it takes, when earth revolves around the sun, it takes one whole rotation. Now what is the cause of a day? The sun rises in the morning and seems to move gradually across the sky from east to west in the day before setting. Okay, beta, what happens that if we are talking about the daytime, so it move across the sky from east to west. Okay, and do you think that the sun actually moves around the across the sky? Do you think sun moves actually around the sky or not? Okay, let's study that what was happening in the past and what is the theory right now. So in the past, people used to believe that the sun revolved around the earth. Okay, they believe that the sun revolves around the earth because of the apparent movement of the sun across the sky. But they have given that like it's wrong. So what was the actual theory now? Now we know better because the apparent movement of the scenery is due to the movement of the car. Okay. Similarly, sun appears to move because earth is moving. Why it was wrong? Because sun appears to move because earth is moving. As earth moves, as earth takes one rotation in 1 year to complete its one rotation. So what happens that if sun appears when earth is moving? Now coming to page number 262. Use a torch to represent the sun and a globe to represent the earth. Turn off the light in a room and switch on the torch. Place the globe some distance from the torch. Spin the globe so that your country is facing the torch. What do you notice about the part of the globe facing the sun and the part of the globe facing away from the sun? Spin the globe slowly in an anti-clockwise direction. Is your country still bright after you have spun the globe half a cycle? Okay, students, in page in figure 12.9, as you can see that if we are placing a torch with a globe, okay, and if you switched it on, so what will happen? It will only shine the half part of the globe. It means if you will spin, so what will happen? That the sun, they are actually representing the sunlight from through the torch. Okay, so what will happen that you can only see the half part of the globe, and when you will spin, it will become a dark there and it will have a light here in half of the part. The hemisphere facing the sun experiences a day, while the hemisphere facing away from the sun experiences night. As the earth spins or rotates about its axis, the sun appears to rise, move across the sky and set before night falls. The earth's regular rotation about its axis gives rise to the day and night cycle. The earth takes 24 hours to make one complete rotation about its axis. What would happen if the earth did not rotate? Okay, students, first of all, they are saying, as I told you, that half of this will is showing you that daytime is there, and the rest, which is becoming dark, it is showing that now the earth is experiencing the night time. And the obviously earth takes 24 hours to make one complete rotation on its axis. Okay, how many hours it takes to complete rotation on its axis? I'm talking about its axis. So it takes 24 hours to make one complete rotation.